choice. Breast reduction surgery. You know, I thought about it, but lately I've been going for the breast consolidation surgery. Just get one big old long breast right there in the middle of my chest. You know, big old nipple on the end of it right there. Now, if I can only figure out a way for it to squirt beer, I'd be damn near irresistible. A little intimidating for most men. It's a thought. It's a weird thought, but it's my thought. There's weird thoughts everywhere, you know. I turned on the TV set. There was this guy talking about how men and women are really from separate planets. We just happen to be sexually compatible. Well, I'm thinking that just about explains everything, doesn't it? Why men walk around all day, women, women, women. Women walk around all day, me, me, me. The only time we ever agree is when we get a common enemy and we walk around going, kids, kids, kids. One of the biggest problems between men and women is we lie to each other. We do not tell each other the truth. Then again, it wouldn't be polite to tell anybody the truth. It wouldn't. We even lie to babies. We do. You ever walk up to a really huge baby girl and say, ew, she's going to make a great prison matron someday. I was raised in a pretty traditional family. My mom and dad had equal input in my upbringing, each from their own point of view, however. My dad taught me how to ride a bike. My mom taught me how to put on makeup while I was riding a bike. My dad taught me confrontation. My mom taught me manipulation. Which is much better. Yeah. Why kick someone's ass if you can get them to carry your books anyway? I have older brothers, which explains most of my brain damage. They were so mean to me, my brothers, when I was little. And my mom would always say the same thing. Oh, that's just their way of telling you they love you. No wonder I grew up looking for sick relationships. They hardly ever played with me, you know. Sometimes I get them to play Barbies with me, but I had a hard time getting her arms back. About a week later, they choked on the macaroni and cheese. Ah, cheese. We had different ideas about what fun was, you know. For my brothers, fun was the marshmallow game. Did you ever play that game? You know, when you put a marshmallow in your butt cheeks and walk across the kitchen floor. Maybe you drop it, you have to eat it. That's the definition of incentive. Then you had to worry about that one weird kid that always wanted to play it. Brought his own marshmallows. Little mini ones. I had a lot of the same girlfriends I had my whole life. You know, real close friends. You know that Thelma and Louise thing. Boy, that movie pissed off men, didn't it? Ew, they screamed male bashing. Oh, come on. More women died in that picture than men did. Actually, the moral of that film seemed to be, men are gonna fuck with you, either live with it or kill yourself. Might just be the way I thought about it, you know. Some things are easier to do with girlfriends than they are with men. It just works out that way. Like going out to eat in a restaurant, much easier to do with girlfriends than it is with men. Something happens to a woman when she tries to eat in public with a man. Some alien being takes over her body. She finds her mouth saying the weirdest things. Things like, oh no, really, you go ahead. I couldn't eat another bite. And you're thinking, where the fuck did that come from? I'm starving! I could eat everything on his plate, everything on my plate, and still blow up a chair to the fucking refrigerator! A girlfriend goes for that last nacho and you stab her hand with a fork. Hey, forget it, bitch. I'm eating that one you had four. anymore. That's all there is. Most women aren't comfortable taking that kind of attitude with a man until after they're married. And that's a rude awakening for most men. Seeing the woman they love with an appetite. They're looking at you across a table one day going, damn, baby. You can really put it away. You used to be so dainty. Yeah, well, get over it, bucko. That dainty crap's history. We're married now and I'm eating. Not like I gotta fit in that fucking wedding dress again, I'll tell you that right now. Shopping's much easier to do with a girlfriend. It just is, you know. A woman can shop all day long with a girlfriend, not buy one single thing, but still have the most fabulous day. You just try and do that with a man. At the end of your time together, he's gonna turn on you. You just wasted my whole goddamn day! Oops, sorry. Women, we bond with our clothes. That's how we find out who our friends are. We go over to someone's house. My, that's a beautiful sweater. May I borrow it sometime? I can. I just love you. But men don't relate to each other this way. Hardly ever hear a guy say, Ken, great slacks. Make your ass look incredible. Think I can wear those sometime? I love you. Just a thought. One way to tell if you belong in a relationship or not is to go on a vacation with somebody. Men and women have totally different ideas about vacations. When a woman thinks about vacation, she sees herself going somewhere where someone can wait on her butt for the entire week. The only words out of her mouth should be, oh, cabana boy. I believe you missed a spot. Men like to accomplish something with their time off. It's like they gotta be productive. It's like, well, if we're not going anywhere, then I'm building that bridge in the backyard. They like adventure, too. I've never understood this. One man actually asked me to go whitewater rafting. Is that a vacation? Oh, I think not. I want the shit scared out of me. I go to New York. Yeah. There I can shop. Whitewater rafting, that's like camping. Ew. That's a worthless thought, camping. If I wanted to sleep with bugs and wild animals, I'd have stayed married and had children. Men like to camp. It appeals to some primitive spirit deep inside of them. It's prove yourself in the wilderness. Cut down a tree with a little jackknife. Woodsy shit. Or is it shit in the woodsy? You know that saying, men don't make passes at girls who wear glasses? Oh, ha ha, most men I know will fuck a tree. Might just be the men I know. You know the only vacation worse than a camping vacation? A driving vacation. Here's a miserable childhood memory we keep trying to correct. You want to get to know someone? Forget about living together. Take a road test. Cramp up some of that premenstrual attitude in a little Suzuki for 12 hours. You survive, you belong together. I'm surprised our highways aren't littered with more spousal roadkill. Driving's just one way men compete, you know. Women, we're very competitive too, but we choose our competitions. Some things we don't even bother to compete with men about anymore. I think men won the remote control war. I don't know how, but they did. And there isn't a man in this room who doesn't honestly believe that a remote control has too much power for any woman. you Captain Control is on. I'll tell you something else. There isn't a married man in this room who hasn't pointed that remote control at his wife's back in the hope of changing her channel or something. Let me see. Playboy's got to be in there somewhere. Oh, we see ya. We just let you have your fun, that's all. We don't argue well together, men and women. We haven't figured out how to argue with each other yet. Men are so boring. You get into a fight with a man, almost always, first thing he does is insist on sticking to a subject. Well, put me to sleep and wake me when it's over. Women, we're fun to argue with. It takes us years to prepare for a really good argument. First, we gotta find out everything we can about their past relationships. You mean she never wore a bra? Well, isn't that interesting? Then we gotta tuck that little tidbit away in that back part of our brain and promise that we'd never use it against him. Oh, honey, it's okay. You can tell me. Then at just the right moment, months later, when you're arguing about something totally different, like where to go on a Friday night, you gotta reach back in that brain, pull it out, and use it on him. Well, just because I have no problem, slut like that last woman you had on it. For 3 days going, what I say, back up, what I say, back up, what I say. How about the movies? We go to the movies, that girl, we go to the movies. That's what makes a good argument. I read about this one couple in this magazine article, they argued all the time. This article said they couldn't talk to each other without fighting. They even argued while they were having sex. What would that be like? We're all painting our own little pictures now, aren't we? What would it be like? Two people laying next to each other naked in bed? Take me there! No, I won't. This article went on to say you're supposed to talk to your partner in bed. Now tell them what you want sexually. Ew. Isn't that disgusting? Like harder or faster or something? Ew. All I could think of was move to the right so I can see the TV. Women's magazines, they don't help us. They feed the frenzy. Every month it's a new issue. Is he losing his interest? Try this, change this, be this, wear those. Okay. Men don't obsess on this crap. You ever seen a man's magazine that said spark her interest with our new sexy sock garters? Men's magazines have articles like bag 'em, track 'em, or marry 'em. We'll say where to find the right license. It's a different perspective. They do a bad job portraying this in the media, too. They make us all look stupid on commercials, though. I think the worst commercial for women right now, that mother-daughter drive in the country thing. It's a beautiful day. Mom and daughter are driving in the country. All of a sudden, daughter turns to mom and says, Mom? Ever have that not-so-fresh feeling? Open up that door and kick that bitch out. And step on the gas. She deserves it for saying something like that to her mother. And what does this mother say? I know what my mother would have said. Well, honey, I guess we could roll down a window. Thanks for sharing. I'm gonna stop up here for some fruit. Why don't you get out and run around a little? But not this mother. Uh-uh. She turns to her daughter and says, oh yes, honey. Every woman does. Every woman does? Think of the implications of a statement like that. What does that mean? Does that mean Margaret Thatcher got up some mornings and said, Ad dear, couldn't possibly address Parliament today? Add that not so fresh feeling. And how does this woman know that every woman does? Who made her the hygiene police? What does her uniform look like? Some sort of weird German shepherd costume wearer? Oh, it's just a thought. They got bad ads for men, too. Do any of us really need to know that some guy's athlete's foot could really be a secondary yeast infection? Well, where's your toe been? And if you're gonna go pussy flipping around, mister, keep your it's a thought. I think the worst ad for women is still that pregnancy testing ad. That perky little middle-aged woman leans into the camera and goes, "Wait a minute, I know whether or not I'm pregnant." Who do you know that says that? Everybody I know says, "Please God!" Might just be my friends. They have a lot of married people out here tonight. You still have the energy to clap? Where are you? Yeah. I just got married again. I got married for all the right reasons this time. This is the first one that didn't ask me to chip in on the ring. I don't believe in divorce anymore. I believe in recycling. Just drop him off down at the center, even though you think he's trash, maybe some other woman could use him. Oh, it's a thought. How many women out there married to men who snore? Yeah, so a few will clap. Yeah, the ones who've been married longer, see, they'll clap for that joke. Oh, men do that. They snore. Women, we don't snore. We don't perspire. We don't pass wind. If we didn't bitch, we'd explode. Spark in a relationship. You know, when a woman first gets married, she thinks, "Oh, he loves me and he's gonna change." Then after a couple of years, her expectations lower just a little bit. It's, "Well, if he loved me, he changes socks in the other room. I need some mystery." Men's underwear changes dramatically after you get married to them. When you first get married to a man, he's got very nice underwear. Then after a couple of years, you're looking at him going, "Honey, whoa, did somebody stab you in the butt or something?" "Have you been in a Turkish prison without my knowledge? This is beyond normal wear and tear. This is scary. This is Stephen King underwear." Men basically believe if there's any elastic left, it's still good. "Well, I know what you're looking at. It works, though." Women, we can't think that way about our underwear. Uh-uh. We got the voice of our mothers in the back of our heads every day of our lives. We get up every morning, we put on our best underwear in the hopes that we're in an accident. Stupid, but we do it. My husband and I went to one of those fantasy inns to keep the spark in our relationship. You ever been to one of those? We rented the jungle suite. Ew. They showed pornographic movies on the television set. I'm 36 years old. I've never seen one. But I thought, hey, if it's good enough for a Supreme Court justice. Well, I had a dilemma because I wear contact lenses, so I take my contacts out before I go to bed. So do I put my glasses on and be sexy, be unsexy in the bed and watch the sexy movie, or take them off and be sexy again is the best. Actually, to tell you the truth, I like the movie better with my glasses off. Then it'll look like two amoeba with hair in the middle just kind of going at each other. Porno movies are too graphic for most women, I think. They don't make them for women, they make them for men. I guess it's just too hard to get six men sitting around in a circle naked discussing their feelings. I think I could write a porno movie for a woman, though. A woman goes into a department store and a naked man sells her shoes. His opening line of dialogue is, "May I say I've never seen feet quite so dainty?" Oh, she's breathing hard. Then he tells her he has the perfect shoe for her and it's only $6. She has a climax, the movie's over. One of the biggest differences between men and women is that men name their private parts and women don't. Last show I did, some woman told me the name of her husband's was Russell the Wonder Muscle. Men do this, they name it. Women, we don't do this. This whole phenomena passed us by. You're never going to see a woman drunk in a bar going, "Shake hands with Big Sal." That's because women only have one name for their private part. It's there. You know when you found it too, because she'll call it by name. Oh, there, right there. He's a neat dresser. Does he sit around the house in his shorts, fart, drink beer, watch football? No, I do that. My ex-husband used to like to tell me, "It's not very ladylike." I told him, "Neither is a blowjob, and you don't complain about that."